Now in this class, we will study about CET and NEET preparations regarding the chapter 2, electrostatic potential and capacitance. Now we are not going in detail about the synopsis here. We are study the synopsis while solving the problems itself. Okay. So let me go to the first problem straight away. The first problem, a mass of 1 kg carrying a charge of 2 coulomb is accelerated through a potential of 1 volt. The velocity acquired by it is, the options are, first one, A, root 2 meter per second, B, 2 meter per second, C, 1 by root 2 meter per second, and D, 1 by 2 meter per second. So here, a mass of 1 kg having a charge of 1 coulomb is having a charge of 2 coulombs is accelerated by a potential V. So we are making use of the kinetic energy of that particle. It should be is equal to the potential energy. So as and when it is accelerated by a potential of V, it gets kinetic energy, that is given by half ma square, and also it acquires a potential energy of Q into V. Now these two are equal. By using that relation, we are going to solve the velocity. The given things are as shown here. Now the relation is half m v square, small v is the velocity, is equal to q into v. So therefore v is equal to square root of 2 q capital V divided by m. Now substituting the values here, so 2 into charge is 2 coulomb, v is 1 volt divided by mass is 1 kg. So that is 2 into 2 is 4, therefore root 4 is equal to 2. Therefore the velocity of that mass is 2 meter per second, meter per second. Therefore the answer is B. Now B is the answer. Very simple problem. Now we move on to the next problem. The work done to move a charge on an equipotential surface is, options are infinity, A, B less than 1, C greater than 1, and D 0. Now what is an equipotential surface? By the definition, we know that a surface having a constant value of potential at all the points. So that means if you take any two different points, the potential difference is zero. Therefore, work done is obviously zero according to the definition of equipotential surfaces. And hence our answer becomes D here. Zero is the answer. Next problem. For the arrangement of capacitors as shown in the circuit, the effective capacitance between the points A and B is, we have to work out the effective capacitance. The capacitance of each capacitor is 4 microfarad. The options are 4 microfarad, A, B 2 microfarad, C 1 microfarad, and D 8 microfarad. Now look at the diagram. So in the diagram, there are 5 capacitors are arranged between the terminals A and B. Now we have to work out what is the equivalent or effective capacitance. Now let me rewrite this diagram. So we can make the rearrangement such that the middle branch, it can be shifted to the right side, and the right side branch is shifted to the middle region. Nothing will happen. The circuit remains the same. Now look at the diagram. Now look at the diagram here, starting from A. The formation of the diagram, we are first in the left side, we are having two capacitors. In the middle, we are having two capacitors, four microfarad each, and the two terminals A and B in the middle, and at the right side we are having one more capacitor, 4. Now next time what I am going to do is I am shifting the middle branch to the right side and right branch to the middle side as shown in that diagram. Now we'll shift them. If you shift that one, the circuit remains the same. There is no change in the circuit. Now this circuit, it resembles a Wheatstone network that we have studied in the third chapter. Wheatstone network consisting of 4 resistors, they are going to form quadrilateral. In the same manner, here also these 5 capacitors are going to form, the 4 capacitors are going to form a Wheatstone network. In the middle, we are having one more capacitor. Since this if you compare this network with the Wheatstone network, this network is balanced since all the branches are having the same capacitors, and the middle one is has no effect since the network is balanced. If you considering that concept, we can remove the middle capacitor because it is now having no effect on the circuit since the circuit is balanced. Now look at the diagram here. Now here between terminals A and B, at the top end we are having two capacitors, 4 microfarad and 4 microfarad, so which are in series. And at the bottom also we are having two capacitors, 4 microfarad each. They are also in series as seen from the terminals A and B. Now those upper two capacitors, they can be replaced by a single equivalent capacitor. In series combination, we know that since they are equal, therefore it is C by N. Therefore, their equivalent becomes 2 microfarad. Now I will replace the two capacitors which are in the top by 2 microfarad capacitor, and on the bottom also we are having two series capacitors. They can be replaced by their equivalent 2 microfarad as shown in that diagram. Now the equivalent capacitance when the two capacitors are connected in series is 1 by CS is equal to 1 by C1 plus C2. I am using this formula for the upper and the lower arms. So 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4, it becomes 1 by 2. Therefore CS is equal to 2 microfarad. Now I will replace the upper two capacitors by 2 microfarad as shown in the diagram. The upper two are replaced by a 2 microfarad capacitor and the lower two are replaced by the 2 microfarad capacitors. Now these two capacitors, now they are in parallel. Now in the parallel combination, the capacitors are going to be added. Therefore 2 plus 2 is 4 microfarad. Now I will replace that branch by a single capacitor, 4 microfarad. Therefore the equivalent capacitance between the terminals A and B is 4 microfarad capacitors. Now look at the answer. It is A, 4 microfarad capacitors. So like that we can rearrange the network to our convenient way so that we can easily solve the problems. Move on to the next problem. Two capacitors of 3 microfarad and 6 microfarad, they are connected in series and a potential difference of 900 volt is applied across the combination. They are then disconnected and reconnected in parallel. The potential difference across the combination is, options are A 0, B 100 volt, C 200 volt and D 400 volt. Now here two capacitors are given, C1 is equal to 3 microfarad and C2 is equal to 6 microfarad. So they are first initially connected in series to a potential of 900 volts. When the capacitors are in series, the charges should be the same. Therefore, the potentials divide in the inverse ratio of capacitance. Why? Since capacitance C is given by Q by V, since Q is constant, capacitance is inversely proportional to the potential, or potential is inversely proportional to the capacitance. On that concept, we are going to divide 900 volt in the inverse ratio of 1 is to 2 because C1 is 3 microfarad and C2 is 6 microfarad. For series combination, the charge is same. Therefore, capacitance is inversely proportional to the potential. Therefore, since the charges are same, C1 V1 is equal to C2 V2 or V1 by V2 is equal to C2 divided by C1. That means the voltage 900 volts has to be divided in the inverse ratio of 2 is to 1. So that when we are going to get 2 is to 1. If I divide in that ratio, I are getting V1 is equal to 600 volt and V2 is equal to 300 volts. Now with this data, we are going to calculate what is the common potential. Now initially they are connected to the 900 volt supply. They are charged. Then after that one, the battery is removed and those two capacitors which are charged, they then connected in parallel combination. Now we have to calculate what is the common potential across the two capacitors. For that one, we are having a simple formula for the common potential. Now C1 and C2 are given, V1, V2 just we have calculated. The common potential formula is, we should remember this one, very, very important formula. So V is equal to C1 V1 plus C2 V2 divided by C1 plus C2. Now simply substitute C1 is 3 microfarad, we will retain it, and V1 just we have calculated 600 plus C2 is 6 microfarad and V2 is 300 divided by 9. Now simplifying this one, we are going to get 400 volts. Therefore, the common potential across the two capacitors after they connected in parallel is 400 volts, and hence the answer is D. D is the right answer. So in these type of problems, one thing should be remember the common potential formula. Move on to the next problem. A system of two capacitors of capacitances 2 microfarad and 4 microfarad is connected in series across a potential difference of 6 volts. The electric charge and electric energy stored in the system is. Now here they have given a system of two capacitors. Let me look at the options here. Option A, 36 microfarad and 108 micro joules energy. B, 10 microfarad and 30 microjoules. C, 8 microfarad and 24 microjoules. And D, 1 microfarad and 3 microjoules. So here they have given two capacitors, 2 microfarad and 4 microfarad, connected in series across a potential difference of 6 volts. Now since they are connected in series, we have to first work out what is the equivalent capacitance. Now in series combination, we have 1 upon Cs is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2, or Cs is equal to C1 C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Now given things, now list out the given things. First we have to find the equivalent capacitance and hence the charge and hence the energy. Now since they are connected in equivalent in series, the formula is C1 C2 divided by C1 plus C2. By that formula, if you work out 2 into 4 divided by 2 plus 4, that is 6 in the denominator. So that we have equivalent capacitance is 8 by 6 microfarad. Now we have the voltage V is equal to 600 and capacitance 8 by 6. So therefore, what is the charge? Simple formula, C is equal to Q by V, or Q is equal to C into V is the simple formula. Now if you use that formula, the charge Q is given by Cs into V. Now Cs is 8 by 6. And potential is 6, therefore charge Q is equal to 8 microcoulomb. Now we have got one value. Now you are not supposed to calculate the second one because you got the answer right now. Now in the options, the charge is 8 microcoulomb. Now look at the charge. Now first one, A is 36, B is 10 and C is 8 microcoulomb and D is 1. Therefore only one option is C, which is having 8 microcoulomb. Obviously C will be the answer. Now here we are finding the answer without doing the second step, that is we are not going to calculate energy. So like that we can save the time, but we will pass on to calculate what is the energy. Now energy is given by E is equal to half Q into V. There are three formulas. In that we are going to use the simple one, half Q into V, that is half into Q is 8 and V is 6. Therefore it is 24 microjoules, and hence the option C is the right answer. Now here, without calculating the energy, if you once calculate the charge, if you have only one value for the charge in the options, then finally decide that is the answer. Here C is the answer. Move on to the next problem. A parallel plate capacitor is charged and then isolated. The effect of increasing the plate separation on charge, potential and capacitance respectively are. Options: A, constant, decreases, increases. B, constant, decreases, decreases. C, constant, increases, decreases. D, increases, decreases and decreases. What they have given? A parallel plate capacitor is charged and then isolated. It is removed from the battery. Now the separation between the two plates is increased. Now what we are going to study? Now capacitance, it depends only on the geometry of the plates. One thing, once it is charged, the capacitor, once it is charged, the charges remain constant, whatever may be the separation between the two plates. Only variables are the capacitance and hence the voltage. Capacitance and potential, they are inversely proportional. Now look at the relations. As charge remains constant, the capacitance is inversely proportional to the voltage with this simple relation Q is equal to C into V. So Q is constant, C and V are the variables. Now we look at the capacitance C is given by epsilon naught A by D. Now here the distance of separation between the two plates are, it is to be increased, D has to be increased. As D increases, C obviously decreases, capacitance has to decrease. As capacitance decreases, the voltage V increases, voltage V increases. So therefore, the options are capacitance, C is the right answer, constant, increases and decreases. Charge is constant, voltage increases, capacitance decreases. So D is the, C is the right answer. Next problem. A spherical shell of radius 10 cm is carrying a charge Q. If the electric potential at a distance of 5 cm, 10 cm and 15 cm from the center of the spherical shell is V1, V2 and V3 respectively, then option A, V1 is equal to V2 greater than V3, B, V1 greater than V2 greater than V3, C, V1 is equal to V2 less than V3 and D, V1 less than V2 less than V3. Now it is the case of a spherical shell. In the case of a spherical shell, now look at the spherical shell. It is having a radius of 10 cm. Now as shown in the diagram, it has having a radius of 10 cm. We know that in the case of a spherical shell, the electric field inside the spherical shell is zero because it is not going to enclose any charge. Since the electric field is zero, what about the potential? The potential remains constant inside the spherical shell. Since it is constant inside the spherical shell, its value is same as that on its surface. So that means V1 should be is equal to V2. Now what about the outside potential? As potential is inversely proportional to the distance, the potential V3, it goes on decreases. Now look at inside the field, electric inside the cell, field is zero. So therefore inside the shell, field is zero and hence inside the cell, potential V1 is same as that on its surface. V1 should be is equal to V2. Now, by the elimination, A, B and D are eliminated. Now, only it will be left with A and C. V1 is equal to V2, whether greater than V3 or less than V3. So, that we should remember. Away from the surface, potential decreases. Therefore, V3 decreases. And hence, the answer is A, V1 is equal to V2 greater than V3 is the answer. Move on to the next problem. Three point charges, 3 millicoulomb, 6 millicoulomb and 9 millicoulomb are placed at the corners of an equilateral triangle of side 0.1 meter. The potential energy of the system is options A, 9,910 joules, B, 8,910 joules, C, 99,100 joules, D, 89,100 joules. Now here a system of three charges is given. They are arranged in an equilateral triangle format. They are at the vertices. We have to find out the potential energy. Straight away we are using the potential energy for formula for the system of three charges. Now look at the given things. Now Q1 is given 3 millicoulomb, Q2 is given 6 millicoulomb, Q3 is given 9 millicoulomb. The distance among them, that is R12, R23 and R31, they are equal and it is also given 0.1 meter. We have to find the potential energy. Straight away we know the potential energy formula. U is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q1 Q2 divided by R12 plus Q2 Q3 divided by R23 plus Q3 Q1 divided by R31. Now we know the value of 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, it is 9 into 10 to the power of 9. So Q1 is 3 into 6 divided by 0.1 plus 6 into 9 divided by 0.1 plus 9 into 3 divided by 0.1. Now
36 it is 18, 6 9 54 plus 18 it is 72, and 9 3 it is 27. Therefore in the numerator it is 99 divided by 0.1. 99 divided by 0.1 is 9.9. So therefore 9 into 10 to the power of 9 into 9.9 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Now 10 to the power of minus 6, why? Because each charge is having millicoulomb. It is in milli. It is given in millicoulomb. Therefore, 3 into 6 means it is 3 into 10 to the power of minus 3 into 6 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Therefore, it is 27 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So, therefore, it is 9.9 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Now, after multiplying these two, we get 89.1 into 10 to the power of plus 3 joules, or it is 89,100 joules. So, that is the potential energy of the system of 3 charges. Therefore, the answer is D, 89,100 joules. Next problem.
Nature of the equipotential surface of a point charge is: options A, sphere with charge on the surface of the sphere; B, ellipsoid with charge at foci; C, plane with charge on the surface; D, sphere with charge at the center of the sphere. Now, what is an equipotential surface? A surface having constant value of potential at all points, that is called equipotential surface. Now, work done in moving a charge from one point to the another point is zero, that we know the concept of that one. Now, on that basis, most of the students will choose wrong answer for this one. They will choose first one, that is sphere with charge on the surface of the sphere. It is wrong. If the charge is on the surface, then it will not have any electric field. So therefore, D is the right answer, sphere with charge at the center of the surface. Then only that sphere behaves as an equipotential surface for a point charge, and hence D is the right answer here. Next problem. A voltmeter reads 4 volt when connected to a parallel plate capacitor with air as the dielectric. When a dielectric slab is introduced between plates of the same configuration, plates for the same configuration, voltmeter reads 2 volts. What is the dielectric constant of the material? Now, options A, 0.5 ratio; B, 2; C, 8; D, 10. Now, look here. Dielectric constant is defined by this formula. So K is equal to C by C naught, where C is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor with the dielectric medium, and C naught is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor with air as the medium. And also we know that capacitance is inversely proportional to the voltage or potential difference. So therefore we can write the dielectric constant in terms of voltage or the potential difference. It is the ratio of potential difference between the plates with air as the medium to the potential difference with a dielectric medium. Now, on that basis, so V naught, that is with air as the dielectric medium, the potential is 4 volts, it is given, and with the dielectric, the potential is 2 volts. Therefore, 4 by 2, it is 2. Therefore, the value of the dielectric constant K is equal to. So, hence B is the right answer here. Next problem. What is the electric potential at a distance of 9 cm from a 3 nanocoulomb charge? So, very simple one. So, answers 2A, 270 volt, B, 3 volts, C, 300 volts, and D, 30 volts. Now here the charge is given 3 nanocoulomb. Nano means 9 into 3 into 10 to the power of minus 9, and the distance is 9 centimeter. If you convert it into meter, 9 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. Therefore the potential is given by 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r, and substituting the values 9 into 10 to the power of 9 into 3 into 10 to the power of minus 9 divided by 9 into 10 to the power of minus 2. Now here 10 to the plus 9, 10 to the power of plus 9 and minus 9 get cancels, and 9 get cancels. Therefore the answer is 3 into 10 to the power of plus 2, that is 300 volts. Hence, C is the right answer here. Very simple problem. Next problem. The region between the parallel plates of a capacitor is filled with parallel layers of air and paper of dielectric constant 4. The space between the plates is 1 mm and the thickness of the paper is 0.75 mm. The ratio of the voltages across air and paper is options A is half, B 3 by 4, C 4 by 3 and D is 1 by 3. Now here they have given a parallel plate capacitor with air as the dielectric. Now one third of that is 0.75 mm of that displacement, that distance is filled by paper and the remaining is air medium. So air medium covers 0.25 mm and the paper medium covers 0.75 mm. Now we have to calculate what is the ratio of the potential or voltage. Now look at the diagram. We have plate 1 here and plate 2 that forms a parallel plate capacitor. Now initially there is an air is present. Now in the next moment, now the equivalent capacitance is as shown in the beneath diagram. It makes a parallel plate capacitor. Now the 0.75 millimeter of this region is filled with paper medium and 0.25 mm of the region is filled with air medium as it is. Now the equivalent capacitance in the beneath is as shown in the figure. CA, it is the capacitance with air medium, and CP, it is the capacitance with a paper medium as the dielectric. Here we have to calculate the ratio of the potential. Now we know that the charge remains the same. So therefore, the capacitance with air medium is given by the simple formula epsilon naught A by DA. DA stands for the distance of the air medium, and capacitance of the plate between the two plates with the paper medium is epsilon naught with dielectric constant K A by dP. Now since capacitance is inversely proportional to the potential, now dielectric constant is given by the relation, and hence we take the ratio potential of the air capacitor to the potential of the paper capacitor. It should be is equal to CP by CA, and that is equal to dA by dP. Now in the relation, capacitance is inversely proportional to the distance. So therefore, potential is directly proportional to the distance between the plates. Therefore, VA by VP is equal to DA by DP. If you take that relation and substitute in the value of DA, that is the distance of the air medium after the paper medium is placed, that is 0.25, and DP, it is the distance of the paper medium, 0.75. So therefore, it is 0.25 divided by 0.75, it is 1 by 3. Therefore, 1 by 3, D is the right answer. Next problem. A 10 millifarad capacitor has been charged to a potential of 100 volt supply. If it explodes, the energy given out is options. Now, 50 joules A, B, 10 to the power of 5 joules, C, 50 millijoules, and D, 10 to the power of 3 joules. Now here the capacitor gets charged after it suddenly explodes and energy is given out. Now how much amount of energy is given out? How much amount of energy it has acquired during charging, the same amount of energy is given out. So therefore here we have to calculate what is the energy stored in that capacitor. That whole amount of energy is released. Now C is given 10 millifarad, milli means 10 to the power of minus 3. Voltage is 100 volts. Now what is the energy stored? Is given by the relation half CV square. Now substituting the values, half C, 10 into 10 to the power of minus 3, V square is 100 square. 100 square, if you write it in terms of 10 to the power of 10 to the 10 power, it is 10 power 2 whole square. Therefore, it is 10 to the power of plus 4. And here, 10 to the power of minus 3. Therefore, 10 to the power of plus 4 and minus 3, it is 10 to the 10. 10 into 10 is 100. 100 by 2 is 50. Therefore, the energy stored is 50 joules. And hence, A is the right answer. So, 50 joules of energy is released when the capacitor gets exploded. Next problem. Three charges minus Q, capital Q and minus Q are placed at equal distances along a straight line. If the potential energy of the system is zero, the ratio of capital Q to the small q becomes. Options: A 1/8, B 1/6, C 1/4 and D 1/2. Now look at the diagram. We have three charges, minus Q, capital Q and minus Q. They are placed at equal distances. Let us assume that the distance between minus Q and plus capital Q charge is R. Similarly, the distance between capital Q charge and right side minus Q charge is also small r. Then what is the distance between the minus Q charge? Obviously, it is 2R. So with this relation, we have to find what is the potential energy. Now we use the potential energy formula. U is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q1 Q2 divided by R12 plus Q2 Q3 divided by R23 plus Q3 Q1 divided by R31. That is the relation. Now simply substituting, since it is given the potential energy of the system is 0, therefore left hand is 0, 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught obviously get cancels. Now multiplying, minus Q capital Q divided by R plus minus Q capital Q divided by R plus minus Q. Now in the third term, the distance between the minus Q charge as shown in the diagram, it is 2R, you should remember, okay. Now minus Q plus capital Q charge, there are two terms, therefore minus 2 Q capital Q divided by R plus Q square by 2R. Now after simplification, therefore it becomes 2 small Q capital Q divided by R is equal to Q square divided by 2R, and hence Q by R is equal to, if you simplify that one, we will get 1 divided by 4. Hence C is the right answer. Next problem. For polar molecules, which of the following statement is true? So simply a theoretical one. So options are, the center of gravity of electrons and protons coincide, the center of gravity of electrons and protons do not coincide, the charge distribution is always symmetrical, the dipole moment is always zero. By the theory, we know that polar molecules are those which are in which the centers of positive and negative charges are separated by a certain distance. So therefore, the center of gravity of electrons and protons do not coincide. That is, B is the right answer here. It is a simple theoretical concept. Move on to the next problem. When a potential difference of 10 to the power of 3 volts is applied between A and B of charge of 0.75 millicoulomb applied, a charge of 0.75 millicoulomb is stored in the system of capacitors as shown. The value of C in microfarad. Now here they have given the options are A 1/2, B 2, C 2.5 and D it is 3. Now look at the diagram. So they have given a combination of 5 capacitors across which a 10 to the power of 3 volts, that is 100,000 volts is applied as shown in the diagram. Now in the earlier class, in the earlier problem, we have made a simple arrangement. So here also we are going to rewrite the diagram, okay, in simple way. Now look at the diagram. We have rewriting the diagram in this fashion. Now the C capacitor that we are going to calculate, it is rewritten as like this. Now looking from the terminals A and B, looking from the left side terminal, in the right side we are having two capacitors, two microfarad and two microfarad. They are in series. Now in the upper part also we are having 2 microfarad and 2 microfarad. They are also in series. In the right side, 2 microfarad, they are in series, therefore the effective capacitance is Cs is equal to C1C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Using that formula, the 2 and 2 microfarad capacitors are replaced by a 1 microfarad capacitor. Now we have this diagram. Now on the right side, 2 microfarad capacitors are replaced by their equivalent, that is 1 microfarad capacitor. Now look at the diagram. Now the C capacitor and 1 microfarad capacitor, now they are in parallel. Therefore, their effective capacitance is C plus 1. Now I will replace those two capacitors by a single capacitor, that is C plus 1. Now the circuit looks like this. Now here the 2 microfarad and 2 microfarad capacitors on the top side, they are also in series. They are replaced by a single capacitor of capacitance, equivalent capacitance 1 microfarad. Therefore, the circuit reduces to this simple network. Therefore, the equivalent capacitance, now C plus 1 and 1 microfarad capacitors, they are in series. Their equivalent is 1 into C plus 1 divided by C plus 1 plus 1, that is C plus 2. Therefore, equivalent capacitance C equivalent is equal to C plus 1 divided by C plus 2. Now, here we have to calculate the value of C here. Now, here given C equivalent is equal to Q charge divided by the potential. Charge is given 0.75 millicoulomb, milli means 10 to the power of minus 3, potential is 10 to the power of 3. So, therefore, equivalent capacitance becomes 0.75 microfarad. Here, they have not asked the equivalent. Here we have to calculate the value of C. Therefore, C plus 1 divided by C plus 2 is equal to 0.75. Now, cross multiplying, C plus 1 is equal to 0.75C plus 1.5. Now, calculating this one, 0.25C is equal to 0.5. Therefore, capacitance C is equal to 2 microfarad. Hence, B is the right answer. Now, move on to the next problem. When an additional charge of 2 coulomb is given to a capacitor, the energy stored in it is increased by 21%. Energy stored is increased by 21%. The original charge on the capacitor is options A 30 coulomb, B 40 coulomb, C 10 coulomb, D 20 coulomb. Now here we have the relation for the energy stored. Now energy stored E is given by Q square by 2C. This is the simple formula. Whenever an additional charge of 2 coulomb is added, that means Q becomes Q plus 2. The energy stored becomes, if energy stored rises to 21%. If 1E is the energy stored in the earlier case, when 2 coulomb of charge is added, the energy stored rises to 1.21. Therefore, the next relation is 1.21E is equal to Q plus 2 whole square divided by 2C. Now, take the ratio of these two. Therefore, Q plus 2 whole square divided by Q square is equal to 1.21. Taking the square root, Q plus 2 divided by Q is equal to 1.1. Now, cross multiplying and simplifying, 0.1 into Q is equal to 2. Therefore, Q is equal to 20 coulomb. Therefore, D is the right answer. Like this, we will solve this problem. Next problem. Two concentric spheres of radii, capital R and small r, have positive charges Q1 and Q2 with equal surface charge densities. What is the electric potential at their common center? Options A is equal to A sigma by epsilon naught into capital R plus small r, B sigma by epsilon naught into capital R minus small r, C sigma by epsilon naught into 1 by capital R plus 1 by small r, D and option D sigma by epsilon naught into capital R divided by small r. So here we have to calculate the total potential at the common center of the two spheres. Okay, now we know that potential is given by 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R. Now here, but in the answer they have given surface charge density sigma. What is surface charge density? It is charge per area. Therefore, I will multiply and divide the right hand side by R. What I am going to get? 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q into small r divided by R square. Now here in the denominator, 4 pi into R square, if I club that one, it becomes area. Therefore, Q by that 4 pi R square is surface charge density sigma. Therefore, I will write it as sigma into R divided by epsilon naught. Now, for the two spheres, if I write the equation for capital R, Vr is equal to sigma into capital R divided by epsilon naught, and the second sphere, V small r is equal to sigma into small r divided by epsilon naught. Since we have to calculate the potential at the common center, it is to be added. Therefore, V naught is equal to sigma by epsilon naught into capital R plus small r. Hence, A is the right answer. Next problem. A capacitor of 10 microfarad is connected to a 10 volt cell. The maximum charge on the capacitor will be? Very simple problem. Now options: A 1 microcoulomb, B 10 microcoulomb, C 100 microcoulomb, and D 1000 microcoulomb. Now here given capacitance is given 10 microfarad and voltage is given 10 volt charge. The simple relation Q is equal to C into V formula. So 10 into 10, it is 100 microcoulomb. Simple problem. Therefore, C is the right answer here. Next problem. The electric force between two point charges separated by a certain distance in air is F. The distance at which they should be placed in a medium of relative permittivity K so that the force remains the same. Options: A is equal to small d, B is equal to d by K, C is equal to K into d, and D is equal to D divided by root K. So here what the problem is, problem in the problem, they have asked the force. Okay, the we have two point charges, they are separated by a certain distance D. Then the electrostatic force is in air medium is capital F. Now I have to keep these two charges inside a medium of dielectric constant or relative permittivity K. Obviously, the force decreases. But in order to maintain the same force as that in the case of an air medium, I have to decrease the distance. How much I have to decrease the distance? That we are going to work out. Now, formula for air medium, F is equal to 1 divided by 4 epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by D square. And for a medium, it is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into K, Q1, Q2 divided by D dash square. That is D dash square in a medium. Now, these two forces should be equal. Now, equating them, we get K into D dash square is equal to D square. Therefore, D dash is equal to D by root K. Therefore, D is the right answer here.